Dr. Maroon, may I ask you how young you are?
Well, let's just say I'm over 70.
In your life experiences, understanding the neurophysiology of the brain and the importance of supplements and nutrition, tell me a little bit about how do you live your life and what would you like our audience to know of the importance of nutrition for the brain and other factors that might help people to have better brain function?
Well, Nick, I think, you know, I've worked with the Pittsburgh Steelers for many years as a team neurosurgeon. And Chuck Knoll was the coach of the Super Bowl teams in the 70s.
Yes.
Great person, great man, great coach. And he used to say that football is not complicated. It's about blocking and tackling. The same thing applies to the question you just asked me. I think living a healthy life is not complicated.
Yes.
It's very simplified. In fact, you've demonstrated this in your own life with your own way you've lived your life. Mm-hmm. But there are four factors. Number one is diet. Number two is exercise or hard physical work. Mm-hmm. Number three is avoiding environmental toxins. And number four is controlling stress. These are the so-called epigenetic factors mm-hmm. that we modulate, we have control over the choices we make, what we eat, whether we work out, our environmental factors and our stress. If we, these epigenetic factors above the genome, basically, we make what's called transcription factors that tell our genes what to do to make good proteins and cytokines or bad things for our body. So in terms of a diet, you know, my daughter, you can talk to her about what kind of a diet do you have, Bella?
Yeah.
I'm a vegan, so I don't eat anything that comes from an animal. And I guess just a plant-based diet and fruits when needed.
And what protein do you use?
Your protein.
And why did you choose that? You told me you were concerned about other protein sources. What was your concern and what led you to look at Slim Blend protein?
Basically, the way I was feeling, I was really listening to my body a lot, and I was a runner, and I couldn't digest the whey proteins all of the different proteins, specifically also pea protein. It just wasn't working for me, so I tried your protein, and I was able to have it at any time of the day, and it always settled in my stomach, so I just really agreed well with it. And it wasn't too sweet like some of the other kinds.
Yeah, we use no sugar. We use stevia, which is an herb, and 30 whole organic plant-based foods with gluten-free, soy-free, dairy-free. It's, you know, another reason probably why your stomach can tolerate it so well, because it's designed as a complete meal with probiotics and essential vitamins and minerals, and I'm proud of it. I actually created it because I was concerned that people were searching for a protein source, particularly athletes, and it discouraged me to see some of these big athletes, you know, demonstrating these protein products. And I knew, because I would talk to some of them, I knew them personally, and they say they didn't actually use the product, but they were paid a big endorsement check. And it concerned me, because why didn't they use it? And I tried the protein powder they were endorsing, and like, same thing, my stomach bloated up. I had, you know, severe reactions, because dairy whey is a dairy derivative, and some people have, you know, intolerances. And it wasn't just the protein intolerance. I think it was the, not just the lactose intolerance, it was the protein intolerances, as, you know, proteins that are foreign to the human body.